what Elisha did and what he went through and how many obstacles was before him. But the man of God stayed the course. And we saw, glory to God, the end result. Amen. And just before I get into the real study tonight, let us just look at the end result. Because the same person that, you know, were criticizing him, that were trying to, you know, discouraging him from pursuing his goal or his dream, those were the same persons who have to come back around and ask of him for favor. Amen. So sometime some persons, glory to God, don't support your dream. But don't worry yourself. They will fall in. Sorry, let me just clear this text. So hear this, people of God. Sometime when you are pursuing your goal, when you are going after, you know what the Lord has shown you and what the Lord has given unto you, a lot of person may not at the initial stage, glory to God, support you or celebrate you. But once you have that self, look here, people of God, once you have that self-motivating factor, once you believe within yourself, glory to God, and you push, once you overcome, person's gonna fall in. Amen. So we saw the persons that were not, glory to God, that were not that were not supporting the man of God while he was going, they tried to discourage him, they tried to stop him from reaching. But because the man of God knew what he wanted, and the man of God's eyes were on the prize, so although there were a lot of distraction, the man of God still stayed focused. And this is what I want to say to you, people of God, in going after your dream, in pursuing your career, a lot of person, a lot of obstacle, glory to God, gonna comes before you. A lot of person gonna try to discourage you. But I want to encourage you, people of God, to stay focused. Keep your eyes on the prize. Amen. There are persons that gonna tell you that guess what, you're not gonna make it. Boy, that makes no sense. And they're gonna try everything in their power, glory to God. Because what? Let me say this quickly, people of God, it's not, hear this, you know, it's not everybody share your vision. And let me tell you something, one of the night I'm going to teach about vision. And it's not everybody you can share your vision with. Because some persons are vision killer. Now, God showed you, but God didn't show them. And so not because God didn't show them, glory to God, and God, no. So some persons, because they don't see it, and because they, glory to God, it cannot work the way how, you know, they try to discourage you. No, not because we are men and women of God. It's not everything that God going to show unto us. Jesus God. I preach on Sunday, and one of the message, the last message I read was out of the book of 2 Kings. I think 2 Kings, what? 6 or 4, somewhere around there. And the Bible spoke about when this woman's child was dead, and she rode to meet the man of God. The Bible told us that the man of God respond was, Lord God, this was happening to you, but God didn't reveal it to me. So it is not everything that God gonna reveal to us as men and women of God. What I practice even in my church, that when somebody comes to me and saying something, if God don't give me a word, I'm not gonna say it. Amen. And if God give me a word, then I'm going to speak. But I will not say anything unless God give me what? Utterance to speak. There are some persons without hearing from God, they will give you what? Bad instruction, bad advice. I remember, and let me say this. There's a shop on the church premises. It is at the front of the church. I remember a young lady. She was visiting my church, and she came and saw that old rundown shack, and she said that, guess what, Pastor, if I was renting it. And I said, what do you want to do? And she told me. And to myself, I laughed, because she said that she wanted to open a grocery shop. And I was saying to myself, that makes no sense, because in and around the surrounding, there is a lot of grocery shop around the place. So I said, that wouldn't make sense. But people of God, I didn't say to her, I say to myself, this woman was convinced that it was gonna be a blessing, and that it gonna, and I said, okay. And we came to an agreement. She rent the place and she start the shop. Couple weeks into the shop, she struggled. I can tell you that, you know, as time goes by, she do away with it and give it to somebody else. But I can tell you that that little shop is one of the most successful shop in that whole community. Even other business place that was around it closed. But that little shop remained and is now known as one of the most successful shops around the area. Now, the problem they are having, they're outgrowing that space, and I don't have any more space to give to them. What I'm saying, people of God, before I shooted down her idea and her plan, what would have happened? And let me tell you something. Nothing is wrong with you try and fail. Not because you try one time and you fail, meaning that you are a failure. No. The amount of experience you have gone, you gather from that one bad experience, that the next time when you go back, glory to God, people of God, you will be more stronger. The Bible told us that the righteous fall at 7 times. But it's not the amount of time you fall, it's the amount of time you rise. So nothing is wrong with you trying and failing. Can I talk to somebody? But it's not the amount of time you fall, but it's the amount of time you rise. And once you look up, you can get up. So let me say to somebody here this afternoon, you have a dream, you have a vision, pursue it. Or when the odds are against you, once God placed it inside of you, pursue your dream. Glory to God. It will come to pass. Let the criticizers, let those who love to criticize, let them criticize. Amen. And let me say this once more before I get into the word. If you are doing anything and you do not have an opposition, don't do it. It's worse when God is inside of it, people of God. You're going to come under severe attack. Because what? Once it is of God, once God is in it, you're going to come under extreme attack. You're going to come under a lot of pressure. Because what? The devil don't want it to come to pass. But you have to stay the course. You have to have a made up mind. You have to, and as I said, Friday night, when you are moving, you know, when God is open you, and when you are going after something, glory to God, you have to tell some people, Sister Colleen, that the blood of Jesus Christ is against you. You have to rebuke some people out of your life. Worse, some person's going to come with some the spirit of negativity, and they will speak some negative things over your life. But you have to shut it down and say, the blood of Jesus Christ is against you. I rebuke that saying. Come on, people of God, because what? I pick up somebody, and it's live right now. You want to do something, you're starting your business, and all around you is just pure negativity, pure negative persons. Let me tell you something. You are going to prosper. You are going to succeed in the mighty name of Jesus. And when they come to you with their mouth full with negativity, don't be afraid to rebuke them. When they come and prophesy over your life, lies that, guess what, it's not going to work and it's not going to come to pass, shut it down. Plead the blood of Jesus Christ. Rebuke them. Say, I rebuke that thought right now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And let me say something to somebody. You need to be careful of your friends. Let me talk to you, people of God. The Bible says, bird of a feather flock together. You cannot be going up and you have negative friends. Negative friends and negative people will suck your energy. They will pull you down. Negative persons is like a what? Crab in a barrel. Glory to God. They will pull you down. They will hold you down. For you to prosper, you have to look for a person who can elevate you, person who can help you, person who can strengthen you. Wow. Can I talk to somebody tonight? One of our problems, you know, a lot of us, we have too many friends that depend on us, and we cannot depend on them. Look here, the person may not have money to give to you, but the person must have a word of encouragement. Glory to God. You are walking with 10 or 20. God, and every time the bills is to be paid, you are the one paying it. Every time somebody wants a loan, you are the one. Every time somebody, what time in your life you can ever call on those persons for help? No, come on. You need to change up your association. Be careful who you associate yourself with. Can I talk to somebody? I am led by the Spirit of God. I want to get into the Word, but something is on the line tonight. God said to tell somebody the reason why you are not more, why you are not progressive, why you are not, because what? You have too many empty barrels around you, too many persons pulling from you. So they are sucking you out. They are pulling your energy. You have to be working overtime to carry them. You have too many baggage, too many excess weight around you. Can I talk to somebody? They are weighing you down. Amen? Amen. So I don't have a problem in helping somebody. But guess what? When my time comes, you must be able to help me. And friendship is about giving and taking. Glory to God. You may not have the money to give to me, but guess what? Anytime I need a word, I can count on you. Can I talk to somebody? Anytime I need a prayer, I know that you are there supporting me, even though I don't see what you are doing. And guess what? Not that I am being negative, you know, that me know it not going to work. And guess what? Me still there. I'm playing an hypocrite rolling. No. I'm not talking that. Not telling somebody the truth. I'm not talking about that. But guess what? Support the person. Believe with the person, man. Or help the persons to make their dream, their vision a reality. One of our problem, people of God, we have too many persons around that is pulling us down. So we need to change our surrounding. When you are looking for friends, glory to God, look for somebody who can help you. Who can help you? Who can help you? Who can help you? Lord God Almighty, look for somebody. Look here. I was telling my officers a couple weeks ago, and I was telling them, because I am not the type of person who love persons who share my views, you know. Me love to have opposition. Trust me. I don't mind when I have like a officers meeting that one of the officers step out and say, Pastor, with due respect, I don't see it that way. And not just say they don't see it that way, but guess what? They have an alternative. I believe that you can question, you can say no. Don't just tell me no, Pastor, me no see that it not gonna work that way there. But guess what? You don't have a plan. And you know, if a pastor don't see it working that way, no. I believe if we do it this way, come on, you must always have a plan, an alternative. But some persons, yes man. Too much yes people around you is not good for you. You must always have person around you we don't share your views, and nothing is wrong with that. Sometimes you have to what? Disagree to agree. But a lot of us, we have too many yes persons around us. And so they will stand up in front of us and they will say yes. And then when they go behind of us, them see a different thing. So we need to change our, you know, surrounding, change our friends, our persons who we associate ourselves with. Glory to God. Bless you. Glory to God. I feel the anointing. The anointing is strong on this life tonight. God said to tell somebody, the reason why you are not more prosperous because of your surrounding, the people that you are associating yourself with. Glory to God. You need to change, man. I hear God say, I want to get to the word of the Lord, but I'm hearing the voice of the Lord. God is saying to somebody tonight that you need to make a what? A shift. Make some changes in your life. Amen. So hear this, people of God. Yes, the scripture that I was looking for was 2 Kings 2. Let me just do it and wrap up, right? So the Bible told us when Elisha was going with the sons of the prophet. When he was going with Elijah, the Bible told us that the sons of the prophet, they were trying to discourage him. Don't you know that the Lord was about to take up your master? That's what we look at from on Friday night. But people of God, after he went over Jordan and he got the mantle, when he came back, the Bible told us that the same sons of the prophet were standing at the same place at the bank of Jordan, because what? They did not know, they didn't expect that he would have been victorious and that he would have come back under the power, under the anointing, glory to God, that he came back with. So they when they look and they saw, you know, those persons, they came to what? Bow down before him and to apologize. Let me just close up there. According to 2 Kings 2, I think we were at what? Let us start from what? Verse 17. Sorry, I'm trying to locate. It was what? 16? 16. So we could start 17. 2 Kings 2 and verse 15. And when the sons of the prophet, which were to view at Jericho, saw, they said, the spirit of Elijah do rest upon Elijah. And they came to meet him and bow themselves to the ground before him. The same person that were criticizing before, now when they saw the fulfillment, now when they saw the manifestation of God upon his life, the Bible said that they came. There are some persons who are criticizing you now. God said to tell you that those same persons gonna come and bow before you. When you look here, when you come out on top, those same persons gonna come and they're gonna bow before you. Can I read that? And they said unto him, behold, now there be with thy servant 50 strong men, let them go, we pray thee. Our adventure, the spirit of the Lord taking him up and cast him up upon what? Some mountain or into what? Some valley. And he said, he shall not send. And when they what? Urge him, still he was what? Ashamed. He said, send therefore 50 men, and they saw 3 days, but found him not. People of God, hear this. The Bible says after Elisha came back, the same negative men, they were saying to Elisha that, guess what? No, we don't believe that, you know, the Lord has taken your master. So let us send 50 men to see. All Elisha told them, no, it makes no sense. The Bible said that they continue. So the man of God said, you know what? Uno go on. The Bible said that they searched for what?
3 days.
3 days. Verse so much now? Verse 18. And when they came again to him, for he tarry at Jericho, he said unto them, did I say not unto you, go not? He asked them a question. And the men of the city said unto Elisha, behold, I pray thee. And that's when they started to tell him about the situation. that they were having a water crisis, that the water was not good and the land was barren. And the same Elisha performed that miracle before them. You are unstoppable, people of God. Pursue your dream. Pursue your vision. Let no man distract you. Let no man stop you. There's a particular scripture in the New Testament say, let no man despise thy youth. Glory to God. Let no man stop you. You are unstoppable. Only you that can stop yourself. The sky is the limit. When no one believes in you, believe in yourself and believe in your God. God will see you through. Can I talk to somebody? I said, all when no one believes in you, you believe in you believe in your God. I often say this, that a lot of persons, even on social media, Facebook, there are persons that sit and they will not move. They don't believe that they are beautiful. They don't believe that they can make it. They need what? Other persons to approve you. But once God approve you, you don't need no man to approve you. Amen. Glory to God. The people of God, when I do even this program, we know that there are a lot of negative comments and not a lot of negativity. I am not perfect. I'm going to make mistakes. I make mistakes and I'm going to continue to make mistakes. Some of us want to be just start out and be perfect. It's not like that baby creep before them walk. And a baby before the walking stage, a baby gonna fall. Sometimes the child fall, burst their mouth and stuff. It is a learning process. It's not gonna kill you. Glory to God. It's not everybody. Look here, let me tell you something. It's not everyone gonna go to the university, gonna go to university. How many persons know that one of the greatest institutions of learning is life? Even though you have your PhD, you still need the what? The practical life, that's what life does. So you are going to fall. You are going to make mistakes. Nothing is wrong. But there are some persons, they just sit down and everything where people say, they take it. So if somebody don't tell them that they look good, you know how many persons, even on Facebook, the other day I was going through my Facebook page because I had too many persons. And everyone that I see that don't put up their picture, I delete them. So if any of you that are on my broadcast and you found out that I delete you most recently, yes, if you don't have up a picture, I delete you. And some persons will put up an animal. Instead of they put up themselves, they will put up a dog. They will put up a this because what? They don't have confidence in their looks. I don't care who want to love me. I, Kevin Sidney Campbell, I love myself. Amen. Look here, nobody cannot tell me that I am not the most handsome man on planet Earth. Nobody's more handsome than I do. Look at me.
Amen.
Amen. When I put on something and I believe, say, you know, I look good, I swag up. I don't need anybody approval. You don't have to like it. I don't do my things for like. I don't do my things because what? I want persons view on me or persons approval. No. Once God give me the approval, it is fine with me. And one of the problems we're having, a lot of us, we are not self-motivated. We want persons to motivate us. Yeah. No, people of God, you have to learn to motivate yourself. You have to learn to support yourself. You have to learn to encourage yourself. You have to learn to love yourself. If you don't love yourself, or you expect somebody else to love you. If you cannot motivate yourself, or you're expecting someone else to come and motivate you, you need to find it on the inside. I don't care what anybody want to say. People of God, let me tell you something. It is a learning process, but I am training my sufficient that I don't care what anybody want to say to them and about them. It don't trouble them because I, Gavin Sidney Campbell, I am not what you say that I am. I am who God say that I am. Glory to Amen. God. This is one of the problems. Persons gonna talk. You know, let me talk tonight. You know how many persons tell me, even in ministry, that I wasn't gonna make it? And now I am seeing those same persons coming around. And when they come, they have to bow. Glory to God. Why? Because I what? There's a sermon. I don't preach this one as yet, you know. Exceeding. I think the sermon is what? Exceeding the limits of the critics. Exceeding the limits of the critics. Because the critics put a limit on you, but I exceed it. Lord God, oh my God, Linton, bless you. Exceeding the limit of the critics. So the critics put a limit on you, but we are going to exceed it in the mighty name of Jesus. Can I talk to somebody? Can I get a witness here?
Amen.
When people criticize you, you must use criticism as a motivating factor. Use criticism as a what? A fertilizer. Put it at your root. Use it as a ladder. Every time they come and they speak negative words, it's one more step and your ladder. So you are going one step higher. My God. Hello. Every time they come with criticism, use it as a ladder. Use it as what? Fertilizer at your root. That it's not supposed to break you. It must motivate you. Oh my God. This is a word for somebody. Criticism must not break you. It must what? And there are different types of criticism. You have constructive criticism. You have negative criticism. You have destructive criticism. You have bad, Lord God Almighty, a whole heap of different type of criticism. But I don't care which one of the criticism, Sister Genevieve Wright, you must use it to motivate you. Wow. Let me tell you something and then I go on. It's not everybody gonna like you. Some of you going around, glory to God, you're mad because one or two person don't like you. When one or two don't like you, God have 1 million or 2 million out there who like you and who will support you. So stop focus on the negativity. Stop focus on negative people. Miss Kitty have something to say. Stop focus on the locusts. We now focus on the locus. Can I talk to somebody? Motivation. Motivate yourself. I believe in God and I believe in myself, in my ability that I can do all things through Christ. Oh, can I get that scripture, people of God? I can do all things through Christ who strengthened me. I, Gavin Sidney Campbell, can do all things through Christ who strengthened me. Philippians 4 verse 13. Wow, at least my daughter know Bible. I can do all things. You can do it. Somebody say, I can do it. Oh my God, I can do it. I am a overcomer. Glory to God. I can do all things. Somebody shout tonight, I can do all things. Some people leave you for, look here, some people leave you for dead, but tell them, don't count me out. People of God, once there is life, there is hope. Can I talk to somebody? Once there is life, there is hope. Never you give up. Never you give up, people of God. And look here, I don't care where you find yourself in life. Never you let go of the unchanging hands of God. Because sometimes God put us down to lift us up. How many persons know when you get like a booming ball, you know those tennis ball, the harder you drop it on the ground, glory to God, the higher it's going to bounce. So sometimes life lick us down on the canvas. But don't stay down. Tell somebody it is for the greater good, because I'm going to bounce back higher. I'm going to bounce back bigger. Can I talk to somebody tonight? Hallelujah. Nothing is wrong with people criticizing you. Nothing is wrong with people doubting your ability. But prove your critics wrong.
Yeah.
Oh, you're going to prove them not with word, but with action. Glory to God. Lord God, there is something in my spirit. I say you need to prove your critics wrong. Not with words, but with what? Your action. Determination will take you to your destination. Believe in your God. Believe in yourself. You can make it. If I had time tonight, I will sing, I know that I will make it. I know that I will stand. No matter what may come my way, my life. I need that song just before I go any further tonight. With Jesus, I can make it. With him, I know that I can stand. No matter what may come my way, my life. You see, once you find it, you play it. Glory. Hey, I feel this one in my spirit.
You don't have to worry.
Lift it up, lift it up.
And don't you be afraid.
Oh, joy comes in the morning. My God.
Troubles, they don't last always.
Oh, remember.
Oh, there's a friend in Jesus.
Oh,
who will wipe your tears away.
Just lift your hands.
Just lift your hands and say,
oh, I know that I can make it.
I know that I can stand.
No matter what.
No matter what may come my way.
My life.
My life is in your hands.
Oh.
So when your test and trial.
My God.
They seem to get you down.
Oh.
And all your friends.
Thank you, Jesus, my God.
Are nowhere to be found.
Oh, remember there's a friend
in Jesus.
Oh, who will wipe your tears away.
And if your heart is broken, just lift.
One more time, I know.
Jesus, I
you're gonna make it, people of God. I can't even see the camera, prophesy over your life tonight. You're gonna make it. You're gonna make it. Oh, wait.
I know that I can make it.
My God. Somebody give him a praise. People of God, I know that you are going to make it. I know that you are going to make it. I, Gavin Sidney Campbell, declare over your life tonight that you are going to make it. Your determination going to take you to your destination. Your determination going to take you to your destination. People of God, your determination going to take you to your destination. The topic tonight, people of God, is not your friend that gonna take you there, but it is your determination that gonna see you through. You're gonna be a great woman of God. Your future is bright. You are destined for greatness. Your determination gonna take you there. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I feel a release in my spirit. I could not move people of God. That word have me a stitch. I could not. The Spirit of the Lord would not allow me to move. I have to say it to glory to God. People, those of you who know me, I tell persons over and over, I don't want to say that, but look here. I am somebody that is led by the Spirit of God. And I am not afraid to speak the heart of God. This broadcast, when I come and hear night after night, I don't speak what I want to speak. It's what the Spirit of the Lord told me I do. Anybody who know me, I try to speak as the Spirit of God give me utterance. Glory to God. So hear this now. I want you to turn your Bible with me this evening quickly to the book of Ruth chapter 1. Ruth chapter 1. In the interest of time, I'm going to skip the first couple of verse, because Ruth, it said, and it came to pass in that day when the judge ruled, and the Bible spoke about a certain man had his wife and two sons. And the Bible told us that a drought in their homeland. And so in searching for a better future, glory to God, for his wife and his two sons, the Bible said that they went to what? A strange land. But the Bible says while they were there, that the man died. The Bible told us that the two sons went and they what? Find wives and they married. And the Bible says, glory to God, that in that land, while they were what? Because remember, they leave their homeland, you know, because they were drought and famine. So while they were there in this strange land, the Bible told us that the two sons ended up died also. So that leave the woman by herself. So that's where we're going to take up the story. So the Bible said, according to verse 3, the husband died. Yeah, so can we start at verse 6 or verse 5? Let us start at verse 5. And Mahlon and Chilion died also, both of them. And the woman was what? Left of her two sons and her husband. So people of God, just imagine, when trouble come, it don't come in one. The Bible said that this woman went to a strange land seeking help to better herself and their family. And her husband died and her two sons. So hear this. Then she arose with her daughters-in-law, that she might what? Return from the country of Moab. For she had what? Heard in the country of Moab, oh, that the Lord had visited his people in what? Given them bread. So now while she was in this strange land crying, now she heard that, guess what? The thing in her homeland changed. And here verse 7, wherefore she what? Went forth out of the place where she was, and her two daughter-in-law with her, and they went on the way to return unto the land of Judah. And Naomi said unto her two daughter-in-law, go, return each to your mother house, and the Lord deal kindly with you as he have deal with my dead son and with me. Now what she said, my daughter-in-law, I am a old woman and I am grieving. So just go, you are young, you can find other husbands. So go back to your mother house. I am returning to my homeland. We are talking about determination will take you to your destination. The Lord grant that he may what? Find rest, each of you in the house of your husband. Or what? Her husband. Then she kissed them, and they lift up their voice, and they what? Wept. Now the Bible said she hugged them and she kissed them and said, look here, go back home, man. And the Bible said the two of them started to cry. Because to me, Naomi was a good mother-in-law. How many person know say some mother-in-law no good? A lot of marriages break up because of some mother-in-law, you know. Lord God, I don't have any witness on this. Lord Jesus. And some mother don't know, say, and some man don't know, so when they married, them have to leave and cleave. I mean, leave your family forever, you know, but you have to, you know, cut off some things. And you have to drop off some friendship and some people. And you have to cleave to your wife. Can I talk to somebody? I feel the American accent coming up. Can I talk to somebody this evening? Oh, somebody give me an hallelujah in the house. How many person know that I have an American accent? Can I use my accent tonight? Oh, can I talk? Talk to me, people of God. Verse, so much we are now. 10. And they said unto her, surely we will return with thee unto thy people. Now the two of them say it, you know. After they were crying, them said, no, we not leave you. We're going home with you. And here, verse 11. And Naomi said, turn again, my daughters. Why will ye go with me? Are there yet any more sons in my womb that they may be your husband? She said, look here. Why not follow me far? Who don't believe say me have any more son in my womb? Who don't go on back home and I don't have any more children? Verse 12. Turn 13.
12.
Turn again, my daughters. Go your way, for I am too old to have an husband. And if I should say I have hope, if I should have an husband also tonight, and should also bear a son, would he terrify them till they were grown? Well, I'm people of God. Somehow you never know, say them something in the Bible, you know. The woman said, look here, me too old. And even if the said tonight me go and marry, I may have one son tomorrow. Will you wait? Because I believe that they were up in age, Sister Colleen. I believe that they, you know, these two daughter-in-laws, they were probably in their 20s, in their 30s. So for them to wait until that child reaches age to get married, good God Almighty, them pass, men are pass, and father pass, and uncle pass. Hello? So verse 13. Would he tarry till they what were grown? Would he stay for them for having husband? Nay, my daughters, for it is grieving me much for your sake that the hand of the Lord is gone out against me. And they lift up their voice and they what wept again. And Orpha kiss her mother-in-law, but Ruth cleave. Lord Jesus, can I talk to somebody? The Bible says that the point that she has made, Orpha say, you know, see a true? After me a young green girl, I know what in my face, me can't find one man. So the saying that Naomi said, it sounded good. So she said, you know what, a true. And she hug her mother-in-law, and she kiss her, and she gone. But people of God, what Orpha did not saw, Ruth saw something in Naomi. Ruth knew that, guess what, this woman is no ordinary woman. And Ruth was going after not just the material thing, but the woman's spirit. Can I talk to somebody here tonight? Sometimes we look for people, we look on the flesh, but sometimes people of God, the word of the Lord say, man look on the outward appearance, but God look with people based on how them look on the outside. But what we don't know that the inner beauty, Lord God Almighty, Lord, it shines brighter. Can I talk to somebody? A lot of man looking wife, you know, them looking for cocoa buckle shape. And I say a lot of them married for just a couple days. They married for color. But what you don't know, even if you're a woman, Lord God, shaped like this buckle, glory to God, don't watch the outside. Lord Jesus, watch the inner beauty, man. The inner is sweeter, it's more beautiful, it's more curvy than the outer. A pretty face and bad character. How many women have pretty face, but them character dirty, dirty, dirty. One of them I used to go dance. A pretty face and bad character. Bless you, Pastor Taylor. Sister Angie, bless you. So the Bible says, and remember my topic tonight, determination will take you to your destination. The Bible said that root purpose in her heart, that she's not gonna leave Naomi. People of God, all what Naomi was saying, it was just going through one of Ruth's ears and was going out through the other. Because Ruth said, look here, I'm not following you because about material things. There is something about you. Ruth saw something in Naomi that she was going after. Tell somebody, go after it. Follow your vision. Do not be persuaded. Don't let nobody discourage you. Tell somebody, do not be discouraged. Go after your dream. Go after your vision. Your determination. People of God, when the odds are against you, look here, because by right, you know, what Naomi was saying was true. The odds were against them finding one husband with Naomi. Yes. So Orphat looked and said, "A true." And she followed it. And she went. But the Bible said, hear what Ruth said. Verse so much. 15. Did we read? We didn't read 14. The Bible said that Orphat kissed her mother-in-law, but the Bible said Ruth cleave unto her. The Bible said Ruth held her closer. Ruth had a what? Made up mind. Here, verse 15. And she said, behold, thy sister-in-law is gone back unto her people, unto her gods. Return thou after thy sister-in-law. Hear what Ruth said. And Ruth said, entreat me not to leave thee, nor return from following after thee. For wherest thou goest, I will go. Where thou what? Lodgest, I will lodge. Thy people shall be my people, and thy God shall, Lord God Almighty. So look here, man. Ruth was determined. Ruth had a made up mind. Can I talk to somebody? Lift up your hands and give God a praise. Hallelujah. Look here, people of God. Me say, for you to be successful in this world, you have to be determined. You have to have a made up mind. The Bible said that Ruth said, look here, I don't care what you are saying to me. I will never leave thee nor forsake you. Wherever you go, I am going with you. Your people is my people. Your God is my God. Can I talk to somebody here? Tell somebody. Determination. Ruth was determined to go with Naomi. There's nothing that Naomi could say to discourage Ruth. And look what's going to happen, people of God. 17. Where thou diest,
will I die,
and there will I be buried. The Lord do so to me, and more also.
If aught but death part thee,
Lord God. The woman make a vow, she make a covenant. She said, look here, let me tell you something. You are my mother-in-law for life, and a matter of fact, I don't want you as my mother-in-law anymore. I am your daughter. Wherever you go, I am going with you. Wherever you die, I'm gonna die with you. Wherever they buried you, they're gonna bury me with you. Jesus Christ. She made a what? Sister Genevieve, a covenant. Latoya, you came on late. She made a what? A covenant. Glory to God with Naomi. Glory to God. So Naomi, she said, look here, Naomi, don't even bother open your mouth. Don't even try to persuade me anymore, because I'm coming with you. Look here, I'm making a bonded what? Agreement. Yeah. And so she made a covenant with Naomi. And when she saw that she was what?
Steadfastly minded
to go with her, then she what? Left speaking unto her. So they two went unto what? They too went until they came to Bethlehem, and it came to pass when they were come to Bethlehem that all the city was what? Move about them, and they said, is this Naomi? And she said unto them, call me not Naomi, call me Mara, for Almighty had what? Dealt with me bitterly. With me. Now, hear this, people of God. When I told you the other night that you have to be careful the name that you give to your children. Now, Naomi changed her name from Naomi to what? Mara. Now, the meaning of Mara is not a good name. Lord God, the meaning of Mara. So, that is your assignment tonight, to go and look it up. The meaning of Mara. M-A-R-A, M-A-R-A, Mara. Hear verse 20, while my daughter looking up the meaning. And she said unto them, call me what? Oh, 21. I went out full, and the Lord had brought me home again empty. Why then call me Naomi, seeing the Lord had what? Testify against me, and Almighty had what?
Afflicted
me. So Naomi returned and Ruth the Moabite, her daughter-in-law with her, which returned. Hear this now, people of God. Let me set you up now for what is about to happen. Here it is. And Naomi had a kingman of her husband, a mighty man of wealth, of the family of what?
Elimelech,
her husband, and his name was Boaz. Now, people of God, hear this. Look how the story gets sweet. The Bible told us, I will ask you, the Bible told us that when Naomi went home, Naomi was no ordinary person, that her husband of a wealthy family member, he was a rich man. Can I talk to somebody? Hear what's going to happen. And Ruth the Moabite said unto Naomi, let me now go to find what?
To the field
and glean ears of corn after him whose what?
In whose sight
I shall find grace. And she said unto her, go, my daughter. Now, what the Bible mean? That after they reap, you know, sometime when they're reaping for market, that there are some corn that left that is not worthy to go. You know, some of them disfigure and stuff. Some of them, they are not tall enough. So she will go through the farm. Persons will go through the farm. And they will what? Gather the what left, as it is known. That's what Ruth was doing. Amen? And she went, verse 3, and came
and gleaned.
She came and gleaned
in the field
after the what?
The reapers
and her what? Up was lighted. And a what? A part of the field belonged unto Boaz, who was of the what?
Kindred
of Elimelech. And behold, Boaz came from
Bethlehem
and said unto the reapers, the Lord be with you. And they answered him, the Lord bless thee. He was a man of God. Then Boaz said unto his servant that was set over the reapers, whose damsel is this? Now, the Bible said, remember, you know, Boaz don't know nothing about her. But when Boaz came, Boaz said, wait, who the little damsel? Because there was something about her. Lord God Almighty, because one, we saw that she was a woman of worth, that she was a woman of God. We saw that she was also a humble woman. We saw that she was humble.
Yes.
So Boaz, the rich man, and people of God, guess what? Boaz didn't have any wife. Mm-hmm. Lord Jesus. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, it is a setup.
Yes. Sometimes some bad things happen to us. Glory to God. God know what he's doing. It's not every bad thing that happened to us happen to kill us. Come on, stay focused, people of God. It's not every bad thing that happened to us happen to kill us. Sometimes God allows some bad things to happen to us. I said God is setting us up. Verse so much we are. We passed for a long time. And we are at verse 6. And the servant that was set over the reapers answered,
The Moabitish damsel.
Yes. That came back with Naomi out of the country of Moab. And she said, I pray you, let me glench and gather after the reapers among the what? The sheep. So she came and what? And had continued even from the morning until now. And that she what? Tarry a little in the house. Then said Boaz unto Ruth, Hearest thou not, my daughter? Go not to glean in another field, neither go from hence, but abide here fast by my maiders. Let thine eyes be on the field that they what do reap, and go thou after them. Have I not charged the young men that they should not touch thee? And when thou art what? At thirst, go unto the vessel and drink up that which the young men have drunk. Now what the man was saying, what Boaz was saying, Boaz said, look here, as of today, I am employing you. Don't go back in the field and go pick up no what left. As of today, you are their supervisor. And I charge them, none of them cannot touch you. Lord God, promotion, same time. Somebody lift up your hand and say, promotion.
Promotion.
Glory to God. Verse so much we are.
Verse 10.
Keep me up to date, no man. Verse so much.
Verse 10.
Then she fell at her face and bowed herself to the ground and said unto him, why have I found grace in thy eyes that thou shouldest what take knowledge of me, seeing I am a stranger? And Boaz answered and said unto her, it had what?
Fully been.
Showed me all that thou hast done unto thy mother-in-law since the death of thine husband, and how thou hast what? Left thy father and thy mother and the land of thy native, and are come unto a people which thou knowest not. You know what Boaz said? Boaz said, look here. When I heard your story, Pastor Taylor, that you have left your family member and oh, you have stayed by this woman's side, look here, there is something special and unique about you. The man said, look here, I don't want to see you with my eyes. I heard your story and your story touched my heart. It showed that you are a what? Virtuous woman. Can I talk to somebody? Hallelujah. Boaz the rich man said, when I heard about you and how you stood with your mother-in-law, it spoke that you are a woman of character. You are a good woman. You are a woman of integrity. You are a royal woman. If Tyrus Riley was here tonight, people of God, I would have joined that song, she is royal. The man said, look here, man, based on what I heard, you are a royal woman. Jesus, tell somebody, it is a setup. Sister Colleen, it is a setup. Tell Lord God, I feel the anointing. The anointing is flowing. I feel the power of God. Tell somebody, it is a setup tonight. Verse so much we are. The Lord recompense thy work, and what? A full reward being given thee of the Lord God of Israel, under whose window heart, come to trust. The man say, look here, the Lord recompense. The man say, daddy, look here, how many persons know that obedient is better than sacrifice? Glory to God. When you obey, when you stay the course, when you stick to righteousness, God will reward you. And verse so much we are. I show when up past 30. Then she said, let me find favor in thy sight, my Lord, for that thou hast what? Comfort me. And for that thou hast what? Spoken friendly unto thine handmaid. Though I what? Be like unto one of thine handmaid. And Boaz said unto her at mealtime, come thou hither and eat at the bread, and dip thy what? Muzzle in my vessel. And she sat beside the reapers, and he what? Reached her corn, and she what? Did eat, and was satisfied, and what? And left. So the Bible said that Boaz said, look here, you see, no, just when lunchtime, come and sit beside me. And you see the same bowl that I'm eating out of, you're going to eat with me. Now remember, people of God, that Boaz was a rich man. Boaz wasn't any ordinary person. But when the uncommon favor of God is upon you, God will bring you before great men. Can I talk to somebody? Verse so much we are. 15. And when she was rise up to glean, Boaz command his young men, saying, let her glean even among the sheep, and reproach her not, and let fall also some of the what? The handful of the purpose for her, and leave them that she may glean them. Lord Jesus, people of God, hear what Boaz said. Because remember, you know, she was going through the field and she was taking up the what left. Boaz said, look here, you see, when the girl here coming through, I want you to leave some of the good ones so she can take them. You hear me? And none of you, don't trouble her. Don't look here. When she come on this farm, let she do anything that she want. Glory to God. Because Boaz what? Boaz have plans, greater plans for this young lady. Verse so much we are. 17. So she what? Glean in the field until evening, and beat out that she had what? Glean. And it was about a what? Ephah of barley. And she took it up and went into the city. And her mother-in-law saw that she was glean, and she brought forth and gave her that she what? Reserved after she was sufficed. And her mother-in-law said unto her, where hast thou gleaned to say today? And where wrath thou blessed be ye, and that take knowledge of thee? And she shew her mother-in-law with whom she had wrath, and said, the man named with whom I wrath today is Boaz. And Naomi said unto her daughter-in-law, blessed be he of the Lord, who had not left off his kindness to the living and to the dead. And Naomi said unto her, the man is what? Near of who? King unto us, one of our next king men. And Ruth the Moabite said, he said unto me also, thou shalt keep fast by my young men until they have what? Enough. And Naomi said unto Ruth, her daughter-in-law, it is what? Good, my daughter, that thou goest with what? With maidens, that they may what? Meet thee, not in any other field. We go over now, because we want to get to the meat of the matter. We're talking about, people of God, determination will take you to your what? Destination. Look what happened in verse 3. Naomi, her mother-in-law, said unto her,
My daughter, shall I not seek rest for thee, that it may well with thee? And now is not Boaz of our kindred with those maidens? That, behold,
the winnoweth
barley tonight in the what?
Threshing floor.
Read on.
Wash thyself therefore, and anoint thee, and put thy raiment upon thee, and get thee down to the floor, but make not thyself known unto the man, until he shall have done eating and drinking.
Hold on, hear this now. It is a setup. Naomi said to Ruth in verse 3, that when you go among this man, I want you to bathe.
Yes.
And I want you to put on your best cologne, your best perfume. And Naomi told her which dress she must wear.
Mm-hmm.
Talk to me, people of God.
Go ahead.
Turn me, yes, turn it around more. Naomi told her which dress she must wear. Now, people of God, it is a what? A setup. Glory to God. Naomi said, don't disclose who you are to him until when he what? Is eaten and when him don't drink.
Yes.
So it means to say him and I'm rum. Verse so much we are?
Verse
4. And it shall be when he what? Liest down, that thou shalt make that thy place where he shall lie, and thou shalt go in and cover his feet and lay thee down, and he will tell what thou shalt do. Jesus Christ, the woman said, look here, go in, make the bed,
mark the place.
When him lie down, go and what? Cover him feet. Lord God, good advice, you know. That's why Naomi wasn't any ordinary woman. I hear what happened. And verse 5, and she said unto her, all that thou sayest unto me, I will do. And she went down unto the floor and did according to all that her mother-in-law bids her. And when Boaz has eaten and drink, and his heart was what? Merry, he went to lie down at the end of the what? The heap of the corn. And she came softly and uncovered his feet and lay her down. Jesus Christ. Remember now, the man eat and the man drunk, because what? It was harvest time, and the man had a good harvest, so things was flowing. The man have money, and you know, the farm, everything was good. And so him eat and drink, and the Bible said when the man went to sleep, the Bible said Ruth came according to the instruction of Naomi, and she lied down at the man's feet.
Yeah.
Verse so much. Seven.
Sorry.
You sure at eight?
Yes.
And it came to pass at midnight that the man was afraid and turned himself, and behold, a woman lay at his feet. Lord God, although Boaz was a rich man, Boaz was a coward. The Bible says at midnight when Boaz wake up, because guess what? Normally Boaz should have gone home, but Boaz lied down because he was drunk in the barn, but everybody else gone. But when Boaz wake up in the night, glory to God, he was afraid. And when he look at his feet, he saw the woman lying at his feet. Hear what happened. Verse so much.
Nine.
And he said, who art thou? And she answered, I am Ruth, thine handmaid. Spread therefore thy skirt over thine handmaid, for thou art near kinsman. And he said, blessed be thou of the Lord, my daughter, for thou hast shown more kindness in the latter end than all the what?
Than
at the beginning. In so much as thou what?
Followest
not the young men, whether poor or rich. And now, my daughter, fear not. I will do to thee all that thou require. For all the city of my people doeth
so. Know that thou art
a virtuous woman, Lord Jesus. Look here, a set up. Some of you gone because you don't want to hear this. Verse so much we don't know. We're about to pray. I soon pray, but let me reveal this. And now it is true that I am thy near
kinsman.
Albeit there is a kinsman near that I tarry this night, and it shall be in the morning that if he will perform unto thee the part of kinsman's well, let him do the kinsman part. But if he will not do the part of the kinsman to thee, then
will I do the part of the kinsman to thee. As the Lord
what liveth,
lie down
the man. And she lay at his feet until the morning, and she rose up before one could know another. And she said, let not it be known that a woman came into unto the floor. Also he said, bring the what? The veil that thou hast upon thee, and hold it. And when she had healed it, she what?
Measured 6 measures of barley, and laid it on her, and she went into the city.
And when she came to her mother-in-law, she said, who art thou, my daughter? And she told her all that the man had done to her. And she said, the 6 measure of barley give he me, for he said to me, go not empty unto thy mother-in-law. Then said she, stay still, my daughter, until thou know how to what?
How the matter will fall.
So she said, don't go out this morning. The part where I want to get to in closing. The long and short, people of God, here it comes. Ruth end up marrying to this rich man.
Yes.
And Ruth, glory to God, because of her determination, she became what? A wealthy woman. Because she decided that she was not going to stay. She was going to pursue her dream. Read verse 16. Get me exactly to that particular verse.
Yes, okay.
Get exactly to that verse for me, please. Glory to God. So in closing, because time is against us, and we have to pray tonight. Glory to God. Ruth was determined. Find the verse for me. Ruth was determined. And that's why my topic, determination, will take you to your destination. Orphat, who turned back, glory to God. Orphat was just there for what she could have, you know, what she could get. Some people come in our life, you know, they look here, let me tell you something. You see, true friends will stay with you through thick and thin. Glory to God. There are some persons that they just come around us because of what they can get from us. And sometimes God to us that, you see, some people, they are not loyal to us. They are loyal to what we have. But good friends, glory to God, through bad time and good time. People of God, oh, you know good friends, you know. Sister Colleen, is when you are at your lowest and they are there for you. They prove to you that, guess what, I am not just here because of what you have. I am here because of you. I value our friendship. So they will be around you when you have stuff and when things is not going the way how it are to what them do. Them flee. Them go and seek not a friends because they are what? So they are not loyal. Glory to God. They are, but you call them wagonists. So them just jump from place to place. Them just move from friends to friends. They just move from city to city. Horfat was one of those. But Ruth was a woman that, look here, Ruth didn't care, sorry, about the material thing. Glory to God. I'm wrapping it up. So according to Ruth 4 and verse 13. In the interest of time, let me just get straight to the point. Remember, Boaz was a rich man, but guess what? Her mother-in-law told her exactly what to do, how to go about it. That's what I love. The mother-in-law could have said, you know what, my son them dead and what, me I go hold her down. But no, she train her, she teach her how to go about it. Hear this. So Boaz took Ruth, and she was his wife. And when he went in unto her, the Lord gave her what?
Conception.
And she bare a what? A son. And the woman said unto Naomi, blessed be the Lord which had what?
Not
left thee this day without a what? A king's man. That this name may be what?
Famous
in Israel. And he what? Shall be unto thee as a what? Restorer of thy life. And a what?
Nourisher
of thine old age. For thy daughter-in-law, which loveth thee, which is better to thee than seven sons had born him. And Naomi took the child and lay in her bosom, and became nurse unto it. Lord Jesus, hear this, people of God. No root because of her determination. The husband that God was way greater than the one she had. The Bible said that Ruth gave birth to a son. And Ruth said, look here, you are not my biological mother, but guess what? You are my mother, Lord Jesus Christ. And the Bible said that she said, as of today, you are going to be the nurse of this child. This is your grandchild. Take care of him. So guess what? She was getting paid for taking care of the child. The moral of the story, in the people of God, Ruth, glory to God, was determined. And because of her determinedness to stay with this woman of God, now look and see how her life ended. So no longer will she have to go on the farm. Now the farm belongs to she, because she was courageous, because she had a made up mind. Because she decided in her heart that if I perish, I perish. Lord God Almighty, somebody give God a praise.
Hallelujah.
The thing that I love about God and these Bible stories, look and see how they ended. It's not how you start in life. Tell somebody, it's not how well you start, you know. Watch the end. Oh, I notice how God deal with his people. We may start slow. We may start small. But tell somebody, don't look at my today. Look at my tomorrow. Oh, somebody prophesy today. Say, don't look at me now. Look here. So tell somebody, don't look here. Don't judge me based on how you're seeing me now. Some of you just looking at me. Tell somebody, look down the road. Look at me tomorrow.
Amen.
I prophesy over somebody's life. You may be the least among your family now, but God is about to turn your captivity. God is about to turn your season. God is about to bless you immensely.
Amen.
Somebody lift up your hands and glorify God. Tell somebody, I'm next. Somebody shout, I'm next, I'm next, I'm next, I'm next. I need that song tonight. I'm next in line for my blessing. I look here, you may start it rough, you may start it rugged. But let me tell you, the latter part of your life shall be greater. I, Gavin Sidney Campbell, the servant of the Most High God, I prophesy over your life tonight that the latter shall be greater. Your latter shall be greater. Your latter shall be greater. The latter part of your life shall be greater. I release you. I declare, Lord God Almighty, that you are on your way to greatness. Your determination gonna bring you, gonna take you to your destination. Your determination gonna take you to your destination. People of God, I'm about to close. I'm about to pray. Hear me, people of God. Sister Yvonne, oh, you come on so late. Hear me, people of God. Don't miss tomorrow night. because I have a word tomorrow night gonna blow your mind. Tomorrow night is actually part three of your determination. Gonna take you to your destination. Tomorrow night we're gonna look at some things. Glory to God. So let me close tonight and say, it's not how well you start. You may start off, you're not bad. You may start off on a bad footage. Glory to God. But tell somebody, the latter part of my life gonna be greater than the beginning. You may born poor, but lift up your hands and declare that I will not die as any pauper. Wow, there is a kingman out there for you. Lord God Almighty, I am prophesying over somebody's life tonight. I said there is a kingman. There is a Boaz out there for you. You have been waiting patiently. And the Lord God same have a rich man out there. Some of you don't even know that while you are working, while you are walking, that there are some persons admiring you, that there are some persons looking at you. And you don't even know, say, that person looking at you. You don't even know that that person is admiring you that way. Glory to God. Your determination gonna take you to your destination. Amen. Heaven bless your people of God. It's prayer time. Give me that song. What the song I request? I'm next in line. A different year. Amen, 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 people of God. Heaven bless you. We're about to pray. Those of you who have your requests tonight, come and send up your requests. I am about to pray. Glory to God. Heaven bless you. Heaven bless you, people of God. And also, we're going to be praying tonight for all the members of Church of God Deliverance Center Ministry. We will be praying also for the members, especially the members of the branch church down there in Greenwich Town. Remember, people of God, those who came on late, that we have lost one of our pastor. Amen. Pastor Moody. She is no longer with us, and so we know that the members of his congregation, they are taking it very hard, and also the members of Chisholm Avenue, because you know, as we're close as a body, but she was at Chisholm Avenue, and Chisholm Avenue and Greenwich Town is actually one church. Glory to God. So we know that even the branch at Chisholm Avenue, it was Pastor Campbell, and she was missionary then. It was the two of them who started that church, and they have been coming a mighty long way. Pastor Moody and Bishop Campbell have a relationship brother and sister, father and daughter, you know, they're very close. You know, so we know that Bishop Campbell and the members of Chisholm, they are not taking it well. So we need to pray their strength in the Lord. Amen. So please, everybody, please let us pray for the Moody's family tonight. Let us pray for the members of Greenwich Town, Chisholm Avenue, Bishop Campbell, and Church of God Deliverance Center Ministry. And also our co-worker, you know, I don't want to say the workplace, but she has been working as an environmentalist. Yeah, let me tell you, I know Pastor Moody from I was going to school way back in the 80s. I know her riding bike coming to Moreton Allied School. And so she has been working with the environmentalists for over several years, you know. And so our deepest condolence go out to the bereaved family. So at this time, we are going to pray. Can I get a song in memory of her tonight? Which song you going to give me? We just want to say it like a bridge over troubled water. And this song just go out tonight. If any of the members from Greenwich are on this broadcast, please. Few of them were on. My deepest condolence go out to them. Amen. I will be going down to Greenwich tomorrow. You know, quick now. All right. So bless you, bless you. Alright, so we're going to pray. Who is this? Ricky Ford Alex. That's Brother Alex. I want to say, Brother Alex, congratulations to you, sir. Yeah, man. Congratulations, Brother Alex. I didn't want to disturb you. But I want to say to you and your wife, congratulations. Yeah, man, bless you. Bouncing baby girl.
This is Kamika
Alexander. Oh, Brother Alex. Alexander. Bless you, Brother Alexander. Lord God. Father, we speak it into being. Yes, man. Touch them now. Get ready, get ready. A daughter coming again, or a son. Wow. Amen. This song is to all the members.
Bless me, Lord.
Turn it down. This song is to all the members who are grieving at this time. All the members out of the Church of God Deliverance Center Ministry. Kiasitan, Pastor Moody is well loved. Wherever, heaven bless you guys. Be strong. We are praying. We are a close family. Amen. And even those who have lost their loved one, this song is for you tonight.
When I'm down,
my God,
oh, my soul so weary.
Oh,
when troubles come, my heart burden me. Yet I'm still waiting in the silence.
Oh.
Until you come and still are with me.
You raise me up
so I can stand on mountains.
Oh.
You raise me up,
my God,
to walk on stormy seas.
I am strong
when I am on your shoulder. You raise me up to more than I can be. There's no life without a strong one. Each restless heart beats imperfectly.
To God, heaven bless you. We're gonna pray. Father, we love you, we thank you, we praise you. God, we give you thanks, God, for tonight. God, we thank you, God, for your word that you have sent. God, we pray that your word, God Almighty, will have a great impact on the life of your people. God, we pray that your children tonight will not just be hearers of your word, but God, we pray that this word will be fulfilling their lives, God, just as so. Oh God Almighty, you have brought root, oh God, out of a negative situation, God. But Lord, her determination, this woman had a made up mind, God. Although her initial stage, God, things was bad, but God, we thank you that the latter part of her life was great. And so we celebrate tonight, God, in confident, Lord, knowing that the latter part of our life, God, will be greater, shall be greater than the beginning, God. We pray for the favor that was upon root life, God, tonight, to be upon your children life, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. God, we declare tonight, those who are, oh God Almighty, mourning, God, oh God, for of the loss of a loved one, God, we pray that you will turn somebody sorrow tonight into joy. God, you will give somebody beautiful ashes tonight in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. God, we pray every single person that is listening, that is watching this broadcast tonight, God, you will touch them. God, you will, oh God Almighty, manifest Oh God Almighty, your power, God, in their lives, God, you will take your people from lower to higher in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, God. Everything that the enemy meant for evil, God, you will replace. Oh God, you will turn it around, God. Everything that the devil have stolen tonight, God, you will replace it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. God, I declare the uncommon favor of God to be upon the lives of your people tonight, God. God, those who are mourning, oh God, the loss of a loved one tonight, I pray, God, that you will comfort their heart. God, there is not words in my mouth, oh God Almighty, Lord, to say, God, but God, thou knowest, only you, God, that can comfort. Lord, we know when one is dead, God Almighty, there is none to replace. But I pray, God, that your word will bring comfort to the heart of your people. God, even tonight as we are crying, God, the loss of our dear sister, our pastor, Lord, I pray tonight, God, that her soul will rest in peace. But God, we pray for her husband tonight. God, we pray for her children. God, we pray for her grandchildren. God, we pray tonight that you will cover them, God. We pray that you will build a fence around them, Jesus. God Almighty, I don't know how they are taking it now, but I pray, God, that your grace is sufficient. Lord, we pray for even the members of Church of God, Deliverance Center Ministry, God, especially, God, our Bishop, Assistant Bishop Kirk Campbell's wife and his family. God, I pray tonight, God, that you will strengthen him, God. Lord, strengthen that family, Jesus Christ. Lord, I pray for the Greenwich Town branch, God, the Chisholm Avenue branch tonight, God. Cover them, Jesus. Oh, God Almighty, we know the impact that Pastor Moody, oh, God, has made upon that community. Oh, God Almighty, so I pray even now for that community. God, Lord, we know that she cannot be replaced, God, but I pray, Jesus, that you will help them, God, to navigate, knowing, God, that if we live, oh, God, that life that you require, that we will meet in the sweet by and by, God, knowing that our only, oh God, way out of this world until the rapture come, God Almighty, is through death. Knowing, God, that death is not a bad thing, but death is a transportation. So I pray, God, that you will help us to live, that when you call us, just as oh, you have called your daughter, Lord Jesus Christ, we can hear, well done, good and faithful servant. Thou hast been faithful over few things. I will make you rulers over many. God, take over right now as we leave everything into your heart. In Jesus Christ's name. Remember, even those members from 127 Windward Road, God, Lord Jesus Christ, God, cover. Lord, I place all the branches before you tonight. Oh, God, we place Seaward Drive, Pastor Enriquez and his family. Cover them, God. Build a hedge around them, Jesus. God, we pray, oh, God, for 127 Windward Road tonight. Lord, we pray for every pastor, Lord Jesus Christ. Lord God, Pastor Taylor, Pastor Scudder. Oh, God Almighty, Pastor Fleming. Jesus, Pastor, oh God, Irvin, Minister Getfield, Minister Charmian Taylor, Minister Cruz, oh God Almighty, Minister Getfield, all the officers, the leadership, God, cover tonight in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, God. Lord, we place Cassiton, Bishop Henry, God, every single minister, oh God, the Blair Smith, God, every officers there, cover them tonight in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, God. See us through this difficult time, God. I pray that this will not divide us, God, but this will bring us closer to you, God, and every one of us will take a page out of her book, Lord God, knowing that tomorrow is promised unto no man. So Lord, help us to make our calling and election sure, God. Help us, God, to live each day like it is the last day, God, for in the midst of life comes death. So we pray tonight, even for the co-workers, Lord Jesus Christ, God, of Pastor Moody, touch them tonight, God. Every life that this woman come in contact with, God, strengthen them, God, for we know that this woman has touched many lives, oh God, across this globe. I know a lot of persons are crying tonight, but while, oh God, hurt, look, while hurt is crying, God, heaven is rejoicing, God. While, oh God, a soul has been taken out of this world, God Almighty, a soul has been placed into heaven. So we pray, God, that you will see us through. Cover every one of us, God. Strengthen us, God. Lord, help us, God, to carry on the legacy, oh God, that she has left behind. God, she has fought. Oh God, I hear Paul, Lord God Almighty, said that he has fought a good fought. He have kept the faith, hence laid up the crown of righteousness, God. We pray that your daughter, God, will receive that crown. In Jesus Christ's name. And God, that we will meet in the sweet by and by. Glory to God. Heaven bless you. Every single person that is watching this broadcast tonight, I pray the hand of the Lord to be upon you. I rebuke every manner of sickness and diseases, every weapon that the devil have fashioned, that the devil formed to destroy you. We speak against it tonight. Every trap that the devil have set tonight, Lord God, against your life, we plead the blood of Jesus Christ against every trap. Fly them Holy Ghost, God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, God. Fly every trap of the enemy, God. God, we speak to everyone that is listening this broadcast that is not well in their body tonight. God, I declare by your stripe, they are healed. So I pray that you will touch somebody tonight with your healing hand. God, you will revive somebody. God, you will energize somebody. God, you will restore somebody health in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Those who are empty, those who are broken, God, those who are in need, oh God Almighty, of money, food. I don't care what your children needs are tonight, God, you promise that you will supply all our needs according to your riches in glory. God, problem in the house, problem in the marriage, problem, oh God, in the family, God, we speak against it tonight. God, those who are coming under severe attack, those who have been bewitched, God, we command every witch and every wizard that is standing in the life of your people, oh God Almighty, we sign their death warrant tonight, God, for your word told us in the book, oh God, of Exodus, that we must suffer not.